What's up, everybody? It's Mobius Y here once again with another tank talk. It was a little overdue here. And as you can tell, I'm going to do the Tier 9 American Medium Tank, the M46 Patton. Going to start with a game on Karelia here with some gameplay. Now, the M46 Patton, this is a great little tank, and a lot of people who have gone down the entire Patton line and have acquired the M48, I've heard it from several people that say they actually preferred the M46 tier for tier, and it's quite understandable why. The M46 is a great little tank. It is a great little medium tank, and it's definitely one worth keeping in your garage. Now, the thing about this medium tank is you got to play it like a medium tank. The biggest thing you want to make sure you do is just to not get shot at all. Never mind trying to bounce shots or anything like that. Just don't get shot at. It's basically how it is for mediums. So I do have my 46 Patton fully upgraded. I have gone down the entire Patton line. I have all the tanks and packages researched. So I am playing this fully upgraded with the enhanced turret and the 105mm gun. So with this first game on Karelia, I'll mostly just explain a couple things that you want to note about the Patton. The first thing you want to pick up on it is that it's essentially what you would expect in a medium. It's not really well armored, especially in the hull. It is an American tank though, so the turret is somewhat effective in a hull down position. And the 105mm, it doesn't do, you know, great alpha damage, but it's got pretty decent DPM and has enough accuracy and penetration to dish out damage where needed. That being said, the gun itself, it can let you down sometimes. It's not the most accurate gun in the game, by far. And the shots tend to have a mild tendency to kind of whiff off to the side a fair bit. But The on-the-move accuracy is really good. The aim time is also pretty good. And overall, this thing's maneuverability is extremely good. It's something that you can comfortably ease yourself into. It's got great traverse speeds on both the turret and the tracks. Good acceleration and top speed in both directions. And my shot just got blocked by that E5 there. I wasn't really too upset about it. I'm sitting right here. Now that the M103 is dead, I can come around behind this STI here and shoot him in this side or the back. Right there, I just ammo racked him here. So that's what I'm talking about right there. That little move I just pulled right there. Being in a quote unquote true medium tank, it requires quite a bit more patience than playing a much more aggressive kind of medium tank, such as the E50 or the E50M. You gotta pick your shots. You gotta, you know, plan your moves ahead of time, pick your shots, and protect yourself at all times as well. You know, once you shift your focus from dealing damage to preventing yourself from taking damage, you can survive much longer in games, and in essence, you know, deal more damage throughout the game because you're alive longer. So right there, I just whipped that shot on the 183. I probably didn't lead it well enough. Now, this 105mm, like I said, it's got decent accuracy and aim time. You can see right there that M103 completely filled my reticule, and Grabby's able to finish off with the 1375 right there. I didn't need to load up an APCR round. This gun has 218 pen, which is more than enough to get through weaker side armor on a lot of tanks, and especially rear armor. But there are some weak points on tanks, even of an equal tier, and of a couple lower tiers, that will give you some trouble. Most notably, it's not even really a weak point, but one of the most notable things that you will have trouble to pen with this gun is the E75's lower plate. I mean, 218 pen against, I believe it's 240 effective armor, 240mm effective armor. I mean, you're not gonna pen it 100% of the time, if at all. So I saw that the left flank had fallen, ISEV got taken out, and the three or four other tanks that went up there got taken out. So I told the, we had the GW Tiger pull back. We wanted to maintain our RD support as best as possible, so I was just pulling back to the flag here to see if I could spot what was coming towards us. I knew there was an E5 and a 103 that I saw over here at one point, so I preloaded some APCR to get to have a much better chance to pen them. If I get a good jump on them, I might get a side shot on a turret or something. And with the APCR, I was much more comfortable with a pen shot. So the E5 just rolled on, and I just got a pen on his side there. I probably didn't need APCR for that shot, but I fired it anyways. Now, that 46 Patton, I hadn't really forgotten about him, but I didn't think he was able to see me, and I was kind of hoping somebody would be able to deal with him. So at this point, I know I'm in a really bad position, because the Death Star and the E5 are right above me, and I've got a 46 Patton with eyes on me in the back, and an artillery just had just launched a shell at me. It looked like an AP round, to be totally honest. So I'm just playing safe. I'm trying to get this E5 knocked out. So even though I lost my gunner, I was able to plant a nice shot right into his ammo rack. So I healed my gunner, and I just stayed close to this E100 to proxy spot him. I was looking for maybe a shot on his top bar, but it wasn't needed. Artillery was able to finish off the E5 for me, which is what I was hoping for. I'm still in a bad position at this point, because I know that there's a T-30, and as far as I know, that M46 Patton is still alive, down in the middle there of Karelia. So I'm trying to stay mobile, not get shot in my butt, and wait for somebody to knock out that E100, which this 57 Heavy thankfully does. So I was very thankful for that. There, right there. My erratic movements and just random turning and stuff, that T-30 whipped his shot. I was very glad for that, because he could have easily taken a big chunk of my health off. So I'm just coming up around the side of this Death Star. I know that as soon as I peek out to shoot him, I'll be spotted from the back as well. They'll be able to get a back shot at me. So I just came out to spot him, get a side shot on him, damage him, and hopefully artillery can finish him off. That T-30 is still looking at me. So the Death Star actually whacked what looks like one of our artillery units there, and then the other one was able to hit him really good. So I just finished him off right there. Another APCR round. So that's 4 of my 5 APCR rounds. And I'm okay with that. E3 rolled around, gave me a hand with that T-30. I was thankful for that. So I'm just going to switch back to AP rounds here, because I don't really think it's going to be as critical of a situation. In an instance like that, I recommend load up some APCR. It's just got better pen overall, and with the accelerated muzzle velocity, you know, you can guarantee your long range hits a lot more easily in this thing. Which is, it's always helpful, because, like I said, this gun can let you down. So I just rolled up, tried to see if I could get a side shot on this 46 Patton. Looked like he was behind some rocks. Didn't get a shot on him, and I figured, you know what, the E3 is just rolling up on him, so he can deal with him. But I'm keeping my eyes on the situation just in case that 46 Patton does manage to rush and get around the E3 and start shooting him in the butt. If that was to happen, it would be up to me to snipe at that 46 Patton and take him out from a distance to save our E3's life, basically. But the E3 was just able to roll up and go, I'm an E3, bang, you're dead. Which is fine. So the E3 spotted an object 7-4, I just waited for him to back up. Waiting for my reticle, boom, side shot right there. This is when a 46 Patton can be really dangerous in these late stages of a game. I didn't realize there were so many of them dead by the time we knocked out the E5 and the Death Star that were in our flag there. But these late stages of a game is where a maneuverable medium like the 46 Patton can be really dangerous, because you can take advantage of exposed flanks and also take advantage of the view range to spot people who are camping or hiding in the back still, you know, trying to pull out a clutch win. And, you know, you can just win the vision war that way, as well as put some accurate shots from long range down into the flanks of enemy tanks that are still alive. So right there, just derped on 2 shots on that 53-55 skill cannon. American artillery right there. But at this stage, Krabby has it in the bag, so bit of a long game there, but it was a good win, and I got some damage in, and that message was actually from the E3, basically saying good game. So it was a decent game, definitely not one of my best, but you know what, it was more than acceptable. considering I was able to do 2,200 damage, and I only took 475, which was surprising, you know, with my butt exposed to that 46 Patton and that T-30 in the middle there when I'm defending the base. But that's what it takes. So we're going to go back to the garage here. I'm just going to open up the packages, and we'll take a look at the packages here that you'll have to go through. So, back in the garage here. Excuse me. Sorry. Let's open up the package and just take a look at them really quick here. So to start off, the 46 Patton gets a 90mm gun M3 M4 GAN engine. So it starts with 560 horsepower with a 90mm that fires 7.89 rounds a minute, 160 pen, 240 damage. So both the pen and the damage are very, very bleh for a Tier 9 tank. So that's going to be why it's important. If you grind this line, you fully upgrade the Pershing. Now this one down here is another 90mm gun. Slightly better 90mm because it has 12mm more penetration, so it's a little bit more tolerable. And it has the enhanced turret with 410 meters of view range. That's a really good view range, especially for a Tier 9. You can outspot a lot of Tier 10 tanks that are bigger than you and have a smaller view range than you, so bit of an improvement in those regards. Now, this next package here is the 90mm T15 E2 M2. It gets another 8mm extra penetration at 180, but it has the same alpha, and it's still the old turret with 400 meters view range. But it gets a much better engine upgrade at 704 horsepower. So this package right here is the final engine, Continental AV1795A, with 820 horsepower and the same 90mm gun, with the fully upgraded turret at 410 meters view range. So, much more tolerable, you're more maneuverable with this package there. And the very final package that I have equipped now, 105mm gun T5 E1 M2. The rounds per minute are cut to 645, but you've got 218 pen AP and 265 pen with the APCR, and now you are doing 390 alpha damage, which is normal for most of the higher tier medium tanks at this level and at tier 10. And you've still got that 820 horsepower engine with 410 meters of view range. Now, it's important to research that 105mm, which you have to now anyways, before getting the M48 Patton, because the 105mm T5 E1 M2 is the first package on the M48 Patton. So researching that on the 46 will make the first gun free on the M48A1 Patton, which is much more tolerable than starting with a 90mm gun on the M48A1 Patton. A 90mm gun at Tier 10 would be quite aggravating, I can imagine. So I'm going to jump into the tech tree here and open up the packages on the Pershing. Sorry about that. And this is why you want to fully research the Pershing, because this final package here, this T40 E4 medium package, has the 90mm T15 E2 M2 gun, as well as the Continental AV1790-1 engine. So if you fully upgrade the Pershing, this first package here, right here, should be free on the M46 Patton. As you can see, it's right there. As well as the previous packages also have the 90mm gun with the 90mm M3 gun. As you can see, it has pretty much the same statistics there. 704 horsepower on the Continental AV1719-1. 790, sorry. Bleh. Too much talking. So make sure you research this package and fully elite the Pershing before you move on to the 46 Patton if you are grinding this line. It will make the grind on the 46 Patton a lot easier because you'll be able to start with this M46 E2 package. And it is optional to go to the M46 E3 package at that point as well, but I believe that has the upgraded turret, so there will be some research there. So it'll just make the whole grind a lot easier from there. So let's just take a look at the equipment I have. Pretty standard for a medium tank. Coated optics, medium caliber tank gun rammer to decrease the loading time, and Mark 1 vertical stabilizer for better accuracy on the move. The accuracy on the move and turret rotation is pretty good already, and it's just even better with the vertical stabilizer. And with those optics, my view range extends to 451 meters. So I'm over spotting the 445-meter hard cap. So right there, I've got a pretty good view range advantage. Now for the skills, obviously it's a medium tank. Start with 6 cents, and then right after that, train repairs. I started with Mentor and Brothers in Arms because this was a crew that I had back on my Super Pershing, so I've had this crew a while. So start with those two skills and you're good to go. Now, the 46 Patton, as you can see from the front, the turret's fairly protected except for the hatch, but the hull, not so much. Your driver's very exposed on the left side there. You've got lots of weak points on the upper hull. So going hull down is quite key if you're going to be trading shots with somebody. As well as your loader is also exposed if you turn your turret. The loader can get knocked out if you get a pen shot in the left side of that turret near the center there. So make sure you keep an eye out for that if you're trading shots with somebody else as well. And then the commander and the gunner can be knocked out on the right side of the turret, as well as your engine could be damaged near the center or the rear of the tank. Now, it's a little hard to see, but there's little white strips beneath the turret on the sides of the tank there where you can get ammo racked. I have yet to be ammo racked in this thing, to be totally honest, in all my games played, so it very rarely happens. Probably don't need a wet ammo rack. Might want to train safe stowage sometime in your first, 7 or 8 skills, maybe, if you just want to be safe. So that's taking a look at the 46 Patton and his packages. So we're going to jump back to some gameplay here. This one's on mines. And I'm basically with the same platoon again. I loaded about 20 seconds late here. I'm with the same platoon, Nirvana's Polly, Boogie Matt, Grab Your Gats Foo, and this other guy. I forget his name. United Combat, there we go. Sorry about that. So, I loaded late, but I still figured I'm just going to try for a rush up to the mines here in the middle, because holding the mines is key to this game, and a medium such as the M46 Patton with some gun depression can really, really hold this middle section really well. So moving up, I got smacked by that E1, and I get one more butt shot in the Carnivon by the Carnivon. I was actually quite lucky he didn't damage my engine there, and thankful for it too. So I'm in this position now. It's really easy to do good from this part of the map in a medium tank like the 46 Patton. Just biff that shot on the Carnivon there. So I'm staying close enough to proxy spot some of these guys if they get the idea to try and rush me here. So from this position, from this centerpiece on the hills here, I can actually use my gun depression and my maneuverability to take very cheeky pot shots and just dish out quite a lot of damage. It's a really, really effective way to play this map with a medium tank. That shot right there must have went a little bit high and hit the Carnivon in the upper plate, and he penned me right in the turret. So he's actually chewing me up pretty good here. I'm playing a little too reckless and aggressive, so just waiting for Boogie Matt to take some shots here. Like I said, I'm just sitting here patiently waiting for an opening as I cannot dink around anymore. I'm down to 614 hit points already. About the 46 Patton, when you start off with a stock turret, you only have 1,600 hit points, so if you see some higher tier games, especially with tank destroyers at tier 9 or tier 10, you can easily get taken out in 2 shots by their 750 or 850 alpha guns. So that's part of the reason why you have to play smart, you have to play patient, you need to use cover to your advantage at all times, and just protect yourself from getting shot at all, because you can get destroyed quite easily. That's a mindset that you need to start adapting to very quickly in these medium tanks, and it's something that you can transition and apply to the M48A1 to make that a very effective tank for you to play. So I came out, tried to pot shot that Carnivon, the Black Prince got in the way, but that's okay. I got a damaged shot, and I didn't take damage that time. So that's good enough for me. So turning around, I know all those tanks are looking up at me because nothing's really stopping them. So I turned around, saw this T-71 exposed, took him out of the game. And he was actually able to spot me at the very last second there, so I got behind the rock here again to protect myself from a possible Arty shell. As soon as Sixth Sense is gone, I'm back on the attack here. So I came out to see if there was another pot shot I could take. Didn't really see anything except for this IS-8 moving. He's not paying attention. Side shot into his fuel tank for 420 damage. Good little hit there, trying to help out Nirvana's Polly in the E-75 there as he's making a strong push. So I came out again and just quickly snapped the shot off. I didn't expect it to pen because I was basically aiming at his front plate, but I had a split second to get a shot off or not get a shot off, so I figured take it. You never know. normally I'm not one to condone just shooting for the heck of it, but if you're going to hit the tank, eh, might as well. So I come out back out this side, I see I can pull out some, and this E-75 is completely side-on to me. Not sure what happened to most of the enemy heavy tanks here, but there's just a one-shot KV-4, so it's looking like the Black Prince and the Carnivon both got taken out. So the C-75 whacks our guy out there by the lighthouse. I'm able to get one more shot at him. He just backs up a little bit too far. So I turn him back around. I'm just keeping an eye on the situation all around me, using good situational awareness. I turn around. It looks like Nirvana's probably could use a hand because there's that Carnivon that I thought was dead. So I'm going to help him out, get another shot in this ISA, knock him down to maybe 2 hit points. So even an HE shell should be able to knock him out. So I come out again, ISA whiffs his shot, so I finish him off to help out Nirvana's Polly here in his heavy tank. That leaves just the Carnivon, who is severely damaged, so I either figure I could peek out and help out, just get a side shot on his turret here, boom, knock him down to one shot, Nirvana's Polly just comes in for the ram kill. Good stuff. And that's how you can make this tank really work for you. Good situational awareness, you know, just stay calm and collected. I whiffed that shot on the T-44 pretty badly, too. Just stay calm, collected, use your situational awareness, analyze the battlefield, and the best thing you can do is just wait for one of your platoon mates or one of your teammates to start drawing the attention of some bigger, badder tanks than you, and just get cheap side shots or even rear shots into their side of their hull or the sides of their turret and just, you know, get some extra damage on there, help out your team as such. So, down to this T-44. He's trying to stop the cap, but he'll get surrounded and overwhelmed here in a second. And I try to close in to get another damaging shot myself. Nirvana's Paula in the E-75 closing in, and United Combat in the Awful Waffle. We'll finish him off here in just a second. He's able to get a shot off on him, though. Oh, I lied. Already got him. Good stuff. So, even though I lost a good maybe half of my HP just to get up to that hill, like I said, really, really strong position for a medium tank like the 46 Patton to take early in the game, and you can just dish out some decent damage. 2482 total damage with 2 tanks knocked out. Not a great game, but I was definitely a contributing factor to taking out the rest of the team. 2 tanks knocked out is never a non-contributing game. So now we're loading up on Pearl River here. Sorry. I sent Gats a taunting message there, so. So I'm going to follow Nirvana's Polly in his E-50 straight up the middle there. We're going to be going to the cross sector there, and I believe it's about D6, D7, and E6, E7. That very center area of this, what would you call this? I'm not sure what you'd call this area here. But it's pretty much the collective center of the map, I suppose you could call it. So we'll roll up here. This game it doesn't go as well. It's not as great, but me and Nirvana's Polly were able to work quite well out in this middle area here, just tag-teaming enemies in our mediums. And for the most part, I was patient. I would wait until they either missed a shot at Nirvana's Polly or bounced a shot on his E-50's good hull armor, and then I would peek out right afterwards to try and lay a shot into them when they weren't expecting it. I missed that one, so I felt kind of bad. So I just flashed a sorry there. I really wanted to hit that, I believe it's an IS-8 right there in front of us. So now I'm just trying to reposition here a little bit, see if I can get same line of sight as Nirvana's Polly. He hits that 46 Patton pretty good. That 46 Patton just backs right off. So I figure if I stay here, something else pokes out, you know, great. IS-8 poked out, and I'm so lucky that he missed there. That was actually, looking back, that was actually a dumb thing for me to do, because I was still spotted. They knew where I was. They could just peek out and snap a quick shot off knowing where I was, and I wouldn't know exactly where to be. I needed to aim to hit them in their weak spots and damage them back. So T-29 gets whacked by Nirvana's. This 46 figures he can try and rush. Doesn't really work out so well for him. Nirvana on the right side here, keeping these heavies back off of us. So this IS-8's trying to just roll in and knock us out. He's annoyed with us. He doesn't like us very much. So when the T-29 splits off and smacks Nirvana's here, this is the part where I just backed off and said, okay, now we can knock out the 46 Patton. Get a shot in the T-29 here. Nirvana sees what's going on. He's just trying to sidescrape as best as he can. We get some help from our heavy tank up above us, and this is where I can take advantage and we can make sure this Patton gets knocked out. Now, I'm keeping this rock on my left side between me and the IS-8. I don't want him getting some cheap shots on me. And for the second time, I just diffed a shot and shot the 46 Patton right in the track. So at this point, I'm annoyed, and I just say, you know what? You need to go. Go away. IS-8 took advantage. He's angry with me, so he put a shot in my side and knocked out my driver. And then Nirvana's is able to finish him off with a shot to his front. That wasn't very good maneuvering on my part. If I was more careful and more patient and landed my shots better on that 46 Patton, we could have taken him out quicker. We could have taken him out more quickly. Dealt with the T-29 immediately afterwards. And basically all of us would have just taken less overall damage. So we could have pulled back and helped out much, much sooner with this push going on on the north side of the map here. So that Tiger 2 just had a bad day, got wasted by all of us. Now I'm just trying to get the scout with that shot there. He was just moving a little bit too quickly. So I'm just letting Boogie Matt and his M103 go pull forward, soak up some shots. Nirvana gets a nice shot off on the M103, start weakening him. So Boogie Matt's still full health, and he's got better armor than I do, so I'm just letting him do his thing and soak shots. So I turn around and see this TD's coming up behind us. And I just take a quick peek at what it is. It's a Panzer Syphilis, so he's one shot. I just take him out so that he doesn't get shots in our butt. And that's when our team base caps with two enemy tanks left. So, like I said, you know, not a great game. It worked out okay in the end, but I could have done better just protecting myself, especially early on there. And if I was more patient and careful with my shots on the 46 Patton, I could have knocked him out more quickly and taken less overall damage. When I just stopped to turn around and finish him off, I just sat in the open exposed like a derp, and that's when the IS-8 finally landed a shot on me. So, going to jump on to Erlenberg now. Erlenberg standard here. And this game goes fairly well for all of us. So I'm with the same platoon of guys. And a couple of us in different tanks. It's just myself, Nirvana's Polly, Boogie Matt, and Grabio Gatsfu now. Just the four of us, but we're still able to get some good teamwork going in this game. So we're just doing our natural spread out from the starting point and just mess around with the radials. Because, you know, that never gets old. Now, like I said, the reason why I wasn't 100% pleased with that previous game on Pearl River there is I lost a lot of hit points really quickly about halfway through the game, and I try to maintain the most amount of hit points possible in all of my medium tanks into as late of the game as possible, so that when it comes down to the point where I need to pull a clutch maneuver on some kind of a heavy tank and I have to take a hit from them, I want to be able to survive that hit. I don't want to be sitting there right on the corner of a building or what, or a rock or whatever, thinking, okay, I need to take him, but let's hope he doesn't shoot me and then high roll his damage shot and actually kill me. You know, I don't like being in that position. And it's not really a comfortable feeling overall, to be totally honest, because when you're just about ready to rush a heavy tank or a TD, especially late in the game, to circle them and take them out, you want to have not just confidence in yourself that you can do it, but you also want to be confident that you have more than enough hit points to take the hit. Otherwise, you'll be playing a little more hesitant, or at least I tend to. I hesitate more, and I try maybe a little bit too hard to try and bait them into wasting a shot, you know, or I see if I can get a platoon mate or a teammate to come over and take a shot for me if possible. And that's not always the case, so that's why I wasn't too happy with that Pearl River game. I was essentially a one-shot when we'd only knocked out about three or four tanks. So roughly a third of the way through the game, and I was already a one-shot. So I'm able to get an easy side shot on this Carnivon, damage his engine there. That was kind of vengeance for his pot shot on the awful waffle that pulled way up in front there. So just sitting tight, aiming in, seeing if I can get another side shot on him. If he backs up here just enough, you know, if he pulls way too far forward, I've got a shot in his side. If he backs off too much, I've got a shot in his side still, but somebody else is able to take him out. So now at this stage in the game on a map like Erlenberg, it's a vision war. So I'm pulling up as close as I can, just trying to stay near a crest of this hill here. I can use my gun depression to my advantage and just peek over this little crest that I'm behind and spot what's over there. Like I said, I've got a really good view range on this thing simply because I have optics on. So I'm just sitting pretty, just inching forward piece by piece until I spot something. And right there I see a T-54, and I am not detected, so I took a pot shot, but taking the shot is what made me get detected. So a little erratic serpentine while I back up to maybe try and get a troll bounce if somebody fires a shell at me. Right there, APCR shell just flew right past the right side of my turret. So I was pretty thankful that one didn't just go right into my hull. So me and Nirvana's Polly are both just sitting here. I know I have to move forward and spot these guys, so I'm just going to pull forward a little bit and spot for him, and he can use his guns, really good accuracy from back there, and take these pot shots on these guys that I need to, because we really need to get something going here. It's pretty even. It's seven on four here, but I mean they're holding us pretty fast to the north so far. So I see the T-54 again. KV-3 comes rolling around on me. I know I'm in a bad spot now. There's an E-75 in the back, so I have to get the heck out of Dodge. I'm amazed I didn't get absolutely blasted there. So I just backed up and put this building between myself and all spotted enemies. There's those TDs up high on the left side of the hill there. If I was to back up too far, they would still have shots in my hull, and they would be able to get easy damage on me. They're just too far away for me to really bother trying to shoot at them, to be totally honest. So I'm sitting here ready to roll, just waiting for people to be in a good enough position to shoot whatever I'm going to spot. But at this point I realized, hey, if I just pull up to this next building here, I can get shots in these TDs. So right there, using appropriate situational awareness, I'm able to realize, hey, you know what? Forget these heavy tanks over here. I can peek out the other side and completely protect myself from that T-54, that E-75, and get pot shots on these TDs. An easy shot in that awful waffle that was really exposed. And they still don't really know where I am. I'm still outspotting them. Either somebody's spotting them for me, or I'm still outspotting them. And it's working out really good, because I'm able to weaken these guys to the point where our northern push can really get something going here. Somebody is able to poke out, spot these guys again for me, so I just aim in, line up a shot. I bounce that T-30's turret, though. But by just changing my focus from what's in front of me to how can I help my other teammates, you know, that's the kind of flexibility you need to have playing a medium tank. I'm playing this medium tank in particular. Boom! Got the T-30, one less TD over there to stop my platoon mates in the north from pushing. Now, it's still 8-6, so this game could still go either way, so I'm just keeping on my toes, waiting for Grabby to spot anything, if there's anything left over there. So I'm just keeping my turret over in that area. Now, I see the T-54 moved all the way over. I just took a pot shot at him. But it was a bit of a Hail Mary, because he was moving behind the hill, and I had to quickly move over, so I don't think I was 100% aimed in, but that's okay. So it's at this stage that me and Nirvana's Polly realized, okay, they must not have much over here anymore. If anything, it's just that KV-3 and that E-75 left over on this side. So Nirvana said, let's go for it. I said, let's do it. And so we crossed together. And there's that KV-3. He's the only one over here right now. That E-75 was further over. So with him, with Nirvana's on the right, I'm coming around behind him on the left. Boom, rear shot in the KV-3. He's gone. Perfect. Now we're up 10-6. So now we're just searching for the C-75. Still playing a little cautious. We don't want him to whack us for a good 500-700 damage and end up losing him about a third of our health. So we're just searching for him together, and we're going to gang up on him together to take him out as quickly and efficiently as possible. So with Nirvana's probably way down in the gully there, he spots the E-75 in just a second here. There he is. So that's when I started loading my APCR. So I just came out from behind the hill, just to aim it a little bit, side shot at the E-75, but I must have hit an auto bounce or hit his mantlet, so it just bounced right off. So Nirvana isn't focusing on the E-75 here, the E-75 in front of him. He just took a pot shot at a TD that was down to one shot to take him out of the game, give our guys in the north some more room to maneuver. So I'm using the radials at the guy that's capping right now. There's only four tanks left, and most of them are pretty damaged, so I just wanted us to get a bit more damage in as a team. In the end, I guess it doesn't really matter. So I just peek over, see the T-30, poop him, pot shot him in the side with an APCR round. So I've got one more APCR loaded, and we're about 20 seconds away from capping here. So I just get behind this rock here, kind of break line of sight so that I'm no longer spotted. Now it's just me, Nirvana, and the M103 that's capping and our artillery. So the T-54 is moving in. My shot only tracks him though, but if anybody else is able to get a reload off, he's a pretty easy kill from that point. So my last shot goes into his turret, bounces off, and that's okay. Base was captured, we won anyways, so we'll just take a look at the post-game screen here. These mastery badges popping up all the time. Just under 2,000 damage, so like I said, you know, not a great game, but I was still able to contribute to the team there by knocking out a couple key tanks when needed. So, going to jump onto Westfield here for our last game to close off this tank talk here. Now, this one here, you'll see that I played it a little dumb. If I recall this game right, I played a little dumb to start off, and I took some damage. But once I smartened up, I was able to use this ridge line and properly use cover and my maneuverability to stay hidden and just get back down behind the hill where needed. So, Boogeyman, United Combat, Grab Your Gatsfu, and Icev here with us in this game. Boogeyman in his M103, Icev in a T-54, Gravy in a 1375 scout tank while he grinds for the Bat Chat, and United Combat in his Awful Waffle. So, we are quite top tier in this game again, which is fine. The scout tank just rushes over, spots a whole bunch of us, and right at that point it's like, okay, well they know that there's a bunch of us coming over here. So I moved up here to this side, this left side of this ridge here, to see if I can help out somewhat. So I see this T-32, he's probably the most exposed, so I just popped up to get a shot onto this hull piece there, bounced off his upper plate it looked like, so. Just sitting here patiently waiting for a couple more guns to go off, waiting for people to be on their reloads before I poke over and dish out my damage. So peeking over, see a T-54 in the back there. He's looking right at me, so I just backed off. Didn't want to take an unnecessary hit. Just playing patiently, keeping an eye on everything. Waiting to see who's looking at me, waiting to see who's not looking at me. Who's exposed, who isn't exposed. There's two T-29s in the back there that are quite hauled down. That T-32 in the back looks like he's going to get dealt with by this friendly TD on my right here. It's a T-15, so I'm not too worried about him. I look over at the T-29s. They're very exposed. This one's not even hauled down, so I got an easy shot into him. He's now one shot, and I told my platoon that, so now all of us are trying to just knock him out of the game. Icev gets the kill shot. My shot ate dirt. And that'll... Like I said, this gun, it is pretty accurate, but sometimes it'll let you down. The rounds don't really, you know, go super straight. So, that second T-29 is very hauled down, so we're not even going to bother shooting at him. So, I just repositioned over here on the right side to see if I could get up this ridge on the right side and get a shot on this perching that just took out the AT-15. That's the nice thing about this tank. It's got really good gun depression as well. Minus 8 degrees of gun depression, if I remember correctly. It could be minus 10. I'm pretty sure it's minus 8, though. Don't quote me on that. Anyway, so just peeking over this ridge, seeing what I can spot, seeing if I can get any cheeky shots in. So I see that T-32 in the very back again. One shot right through his plate. He's done before anybody can retaliate. So that's a good kill right there. One more gun on their team knocked out. So we're up 7-2 at this point. Things are going quite well. So I poke over. And I figure we need this T-54 gone, so I get one easy shot into him. Now that J-Panther, I don't know if the J-Panther is what was looking at me, but upon spotting him, I got a lot more cautious, because he's in a pretty good position to lay down some hurt And if he has the big gun, he can actually hit me for a lot of damage. This T-32 started getting in my way for some reason. I was trying to maneuver on this area. That's why I flashed the fallback. Because right where I poked out is right where he wanted to be. And earlier, he almost blocked me from backing up. So I just said, you know what? I'm just going to go over here now. You take that spot if you want it. And he got blasted for it. So that's when we see where the T-95 is. And he's got the big gun. He's got the 155, so he can hit me pretty hard. So I'm just using the ridge to stay protected, trying to spot them out. Playing it safe, just trying to spot them out, but that T-95 is actually able to outspot me. Looks like he's got a camo net parked up on him. So I see ISEV is quite weak in town here, so I just try to reposition. Maybe I can get a shot on him, but he ends up taking care of it himself. And I spot that tortoise again, but something is still spotting me from in the distance there. I'm not sure what it is. It could be the tortoise. It could be the T-95. Who knows? Something with Binox up right now. It could even be that Jake Panther 2 if it's still alive, for all I know. But we'll see. So T-29 gets spotted again. This is one of the two T-29s we saw very early. Now I see this E-50 is rushing Grabby. So I got a side shot into his turret there. He was quite exposed, and I was able to get an easy shot into his side. Unfortunately, Grabio Gats got taken out as a result of that, so E-50 is still side-on to me for the most part. I got a shot at him, but he's turning his hull and his turret back towards me, so that's why that one bounced. So I figured the E-50 would actually come towards us, but instead he hangs back and sits hull down. So I know I can pen the front of his turret, but I'm not counting on it to be every shot. I expected to miss like that previous shot, or just hit his gun mantlet and bounce like that shot right there. Either way, I was quite confident that I'd be able to trade shots with this E-50. At this point, it would be much harder for him to hit my cupola and damage, or sorry, cupola, whatever you want to call it, cupola. Put the proper emphasis on the correct syllable. But I knew I could trade shots with this E-50 because it's harder for him to hit my little commander's hatch on my tank, and I could just hit the face of his turret, not the gun mantlet, and damage him from any point there. So I see he's still just sitting there. That shot hit his mantlet, so it bounced. Still just trading shots with this E-50. Eventually, I figured, you know, eventually these shots are going to start hitting again. But he starts moving. I look over, and finally the T-95 gets taken out. It looks like a push on the east side of the map was quite successful, and they're starting to come up that side of the hill. So E-50 gets whacked by a friendly, and I put one more shot at him, and it also bounces. And this is to be expected when shooting at a hull-down E-50. And then I see his turret side. He backs up just too far, and I'm able to get an easy side shot on him and finish him off. Now, from this point, it's just a T-30 left over, so we're all just closing in to finish him off from here on out. ISEV's closing in. We've got Boogeyman on my right side with the M103. Two more heavy tanks behind me, so as soon as that T-30 gets spotted, he's going to have pretty much five guns trained on him, and this will be a quick, efficient way to finish off the game. T-30 takes out ISEV, though, so. And my last shot of the game coming up here. I'm just waiting for that T-30 to come up and be a little bit more exposed. I'm not sure where that shot went. It looks like I went over him and missed. But I'll be able to get one more shot off on him. I was hoping to get in the side of his turret, but I ended up just hitting his gun and damaging him there. So, that's it for that game there. Take a look at the post game, see how much damage I did. I wasn't expecting a lot of damage again, but like I said, knocked out a couple tanks where needed. Got some extra damage on tanks that needed to be damaged more so that they could be taken out much more quickly. So, only 1856 damage. Not a stellar game, but, you know, still a good contributing game with two tanks destroyed. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this tank talk. M46 Patton, Tier 9 American Medium Tank. Definitely a keeper for the garage. Really fun tank to play. So, I hope you all enjoyed watching. Mobius Y signing off. We'll see you next time.